Hi everybody, my name is Olivia Gudaniec, and today we're here with Spencer Macpherson. Am I right?
You're right.
Okay, good, because I did not want to screw that one up. So Spencer here is an actor. You've been working on Degrassi as Hunter Hollingsworth.
Right.
So that's been a couple of years now.
Yeah, so I'm filming my third season.
Wow, so not only are you getting a steady paycheck, but you get to see your character evolve.
Yes.
So how have you as an actor, I guess, grown, and how has Hunter changed?
Well, over the seasons, yeah, like at first I wasn't given much to go on about my character, but as it develops, as you find more about it, you can really flesh it out, and for Hunter, he's really evolved, I think. Over the span of the show, I think they always knew the roots of what he would be, but really get to, I think as the actor, it's fun to get to flesh out the character more and more, yeah.
So he starts off really introverted?
Yeah, he's a very introverted character, and he lives his life kind of vicariously through this video game. And you see like little, he's got these bursts of anger, and you don't know, he's very troubled, you don't know what he wants to do with this, but yeah.
That's awesome. And I heard Degrassi is going now to Netflix.
Yes.
How do you feel about that? How does the cast feel about that? Is it positive?
It's a really positive feeling overall, yeah. I think the big thing is that with Netflix, there's less boundaries. There's less people saying, can't do that, can't do this. It's overall just like, it's even reflecting, I think, in like the stories we're getting to tell, and like performances are more raw, and like it's just overall, I think everyone's really excited about it.
And people do love their Netflix.
They do love their Netflix.
So Degrassi, how is that similar, say, to your high school at Cothra?
I just graduated, but
congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
Lots of good things happening for this guy. It's your year.
Obviously Cothra is just a normal kind of school. Degrassi, on the other hand,
a little hanged.
I don't know why they don't just shut it down by now. There's so much bad stuff going on.
It will prevail.
It will, yes.
And you've also been working on Defiance.
Yes, I have.
So you had a dual role on that.
Yeah.
How did that come about? Were there two separate auditions?
It was two completely separate auditions. The way it works with that show is it's like, since everyone gets to be these different like races of aliens and stuff, it's really like melting pot of all these different cultures, like races of aliens, with the first part I played, I was a human, and I tried out for it, and it went really well. It wasn't that big of a part, and then the second part I played, ran a car. I had 2 hours of prosthetics,
wow.
And I looked totally different.
Did you have to speak another language too?
Yeah, there's a native tongue that they speak, but then he also speaks English. So yeah, it was a really cool show to be on. Really great experience.
I've been on that set too, so it's pretty neat.
Yeah.
Everyone's
walking around looking like aliens.
Yeah, it's like, where am I? What time period? You're just hopping around from all time periods.
I am, yeah.
Speaking of time periods, you're on train now.
I am, yes.
So you're playing Charles. Lots of responsibility there. So how's that going? I know you have to do an accent. And through a ton of social media, you've said that through watching the Harry Potter series, you kind of mastered the accent that way.
Well, with Degrassi, there was a brief point where like I was using an accent over the game, and that was straight up just like me trying to do Harry Potter.
I love Harry Potter.
I'm a huge fan of Harry Potter. Yeah. That's kind of, I think naturally my voice just kind of sounds a little bit like that when I try and do a British accent. But with Rain, though, I have, it is a little bit of a different accent for sure, because Charles, being this royal, he speaks with an Aubrey accent, and he's very
sophisticated
and elegant, and holds himself differently.
And exactly, we even have to sit up straighter to say. Is that intimidating, to have to do an accent when your co-workers are naturally British?
It's like, it's a challenge for sure, but I've spoken to them, and they've all done, things where they've been done in an American accent, and I think it's just, it's a really fun way to get to really remove yourself from anything you've done before, you know.
It's a cool experience for sure. So do you have a coach for that?
The way it works actually is with the people at Rain, they kind of, before I film an episode, I have like a Skype session with the dialect coach. It's really fun.
So between that and your coaching, I guess that's...
That's all, yeah.
So I think I'm going to test you. So the last question, I would love for you to answer in a British accent.
All right.
So if there was another job you could do on set, Spencer, what would it be and why?
Well, I have to say that another job I'd like to do would be directing, because you really control the vision of the show, and you know, what you say goes. I'd definitely like to try that. But yeah, I'm an actor at heart, so I'm doing that.
That's bloody brilliant. Thank you very much. Cheerio, everybody.
Yeah. See you.